Hello, namaste, welcome back to my channel, Padma's Universe. My name is Padma. So this is an unplanned vlog. It's evening 4:15 PM and it's Wednesday today. Kids' holidays have started. So I am visiting an Ayurvedic doctor today. I have an appointment with him and I'm also dragging my elder one, Yash, along with me. And he never wanted to come because he's busy playing cricket and he was so annoyed when I called him. The reason why I'm visiting the doctor is I have extremely dry skin right here. Above my palm, what do you call this area? I don't know. But then yes, it's extremely dry. I don't have any itching as such, so I have to keep the area moisturized. And I've tried everything, right from coconut oil to all kinds of moisturizers to anything and everything. So this, I feel the skin is just drinking the moisturizer, and almost every half an hour I have to reapply. So nothing was working. And it is getting chapped, cracked, extremely dry. So how else do I describe? So it is not looking good. So I thought, let me go consult. Initially I wanted to go to a skin doctor, but then the Ayurvedic medicines seem to work for me. So I thought, let me go visit. Apart from this, there are a couple of issues which I wanted to consult. I actually applied the aloe vera gel, not the commercial ones, but then I have aloe vera plant in my balcony. So I applied the aloe vera gel fresh out of the plant and it worked like magic. And that is the only thing which I'm using right now. But then it fixes the problem temporarily. So I wanted a permanent solution for this. I wanted to know what's the root cause, because only during winters I used to experience this, but now it's summers and it is still continuing. And yeah, I wanted to consult for a couple of other issues, because I feel that I was feeling extremely tired, lethargic. So I recently had a health checkup done, and touch wood, perfectly fine. The reports were absolutely fine, no issues, except for a couple of things that I have: very low calcium and low hemoglobin, and that is something which is very common after childbirth, and you know, when for the ladies. So I have very low hemoglobin, so maybe that's one of the reasons. Let me show you the plant. This is my beautiful plant, and do try to have this plant at your place. And I also have another plant which is in my other balcony, and there are new plants growing actually. So and they say that it also purifies the air. So I think one aloe vera plant at your place is a must and should. So I wanted to go check on my why am I feeling so tired, lethargic. I know the hemoglobin, because I recently, last week, I got my blood test done. I wanted to check on my hemoglobin, so it's come down. So maybe that is the reason, but even otherwise I wanted to go check. And also I have some breathing issues, in the sense I feel maybe it is psychological. I feel I'm getting choked, as in I'm not able to breathe free, especially when I am sleeping. So I have to change positions. So otherwise I don't have any cold, no nasal block, nothing. So but it doesn't happen always, it doesn't happen every day. Sometimes when I breathe in, I feel the air is not reaching inside. So all those things. And for my son, he has this perennial tonsil problem, and a couple of days back he had some stomach upset. So he was complaining of that he always feels pukish. So, and also he coughs whenever he plays vigorous sports. When he's running, he coughs. So I thought, if I'm going, I'll also drag, because he is on Ayurvedic medicines and it works wonderfully well for him. So I thought, let's go do a quick health checkup, as in quick consultation. So this is what I prepared for lunch. Very simple veg lunch: buttermilk curry, that is more korambu, white rice, and this is some brinjal fry, which is awesome. Very, very plain, simple dish, but then it tastes so good. It tastes equally good with rice and chapati and some carrot stir fry. So so for my son, I stopped giving him the usual regular allopathic medicine, so the Ayurvedic medicines. I think for us, especially ladies, we need to go. I am a very lazy person when it comes to, I hate going to hospitals or clinics or you know, consulting doctors. But I think we should take time out, because if we are healthy, the family is healthy, we can keep them healthy. So yes, let's go. And for dinner, this is it. I'm not planning to make anything else, but kids have some other plans. They're planning to order pizza, so that is their plan. And this is what I'm wearing: very comfortable kurti and a legging, which is super comfortable. It feels like a second skin actually. It is so good. I had to bribe Yash. Yash is finally here, so I am offering him Chaat. He loves Chaat, so this is my cutie bag, which otherwise I don't carry anything else except for a big jute bag because I tend to shop unplanned. So if at all I need to buy something, so this bag is so handy and I'm gonna use this. So let's go. So as I said, I have bribed Yash. So after we finish consulting, we are planning to have some Chaat, and Yash is planning to order some pizzas. So he wanted to have pizza. So today my husband is working from home and the little one is not with us because he doesn't even know, because if he knows that we are out, he thinks that okay, there is some plan happening and we are going somewhere, blah blah blah. So he doesn't know, he's playing, busy playing. So I was telling Yash that if you want Chaat, then no pizza, but then he wants both. So we finished consulting doctor and I thought let me buy some fresh fish if it is fresh and some other knickknacks for home. We enjoyed the Chaats. The thing is, eating healthy always is also boring, so we need to indulge ourselves, and it is okay if we eat Chaat. I know it is unhealthy, especially street food, and I honestly like to eat Chaat from small vendors. I mean, if they give you in a platter in a very very ultra organized way with mineral water and all that, I don't enjoy. I seriously don't enjoy. So I enjoy it in a place like this. Places like this, what is the fine? I mean, it's a street food, so we should have it on streets. It is okay as long as our immunity is strong, and I don't mind giving it to my kids once in a while. I don't remember when we had Chaat the last time, so that is how it is. One life we should enjoy, as long as it doesn't tamper our health. So we finished. So I asked my husband to come and pick because my bag was pretty heavy, and my son was making fun of me saying that you always go saying that I have nothing to shop. I just wanted to pick some vegetables and fish, but then I ended up buying so much. He said, Amma, next time when you come, bring a suitcase. Not one, but bring 2-3 so that it is convenient for you. How do you manage? So I said, okay, fine, I'll take that feedback. So we are going home, and yeah, the consultation was fine. The doctor said, oh, absolutely fine for my skin. He has given me some Ayurvedic churan and an Ayurvedic ointment, which is nothing but medicated ghee, and a liquid medicine which is kashayam, so to bring down the body heat. So that's it. And for Yash, he said nothing, he's absolutely fine, just observe him, otherwise there is no medicines for him, he's fine. So we reached home, and I'm going to make tea for myself, and kids are deciding on what pizzas to buy. They've already decided what pizza to buy and which pizza to buy, and Yash is making Athar cry. So that is the usual thing.
Plain pizza. Without anything, only crust.
But before that, I need to keep the fish in the freezer because today I'm not planning to cook the fish. So it's for tomorrow. So tomorrow I'm going to be making fish fry and fish curry. So this is over 2 kilos of fish. I got Rohu, which is my favorite fish. And it's very tasty and it is very fresh. Look at these stains. So I'm not going to wash or clean the fish. I'm going to freeze it as it is, and tomorrow I will clean it. Or else you can marinate and keep. So I'm not planning to do that. I'm going to store it, freeze it as it is. So I wanted to show you one more thing. At the Chaat shop, I saw these packets of tamarind chutney, which is nothing but sweet chutney. So and the green chutney. So these you can make it very, yeah, very simple. You can make it easily at home, and it turns out much more tastier than these packaged, because they use preservatives in this. But then the reason for me buying these are for the videos, because whenever I make a video, especially for my son's video channel, you make the dish and then you need to season it with these chutneys. So at that point in time, it is not possible to make these chutneys. So for the video purpose, I got these chutneys, but then I always prefer making these at home and they turn out awesome. So at the Chaat shop, the chutneys which they serve are diluted. So when you make them at home, they are 10 times better. So these chutneys, that is the tamarind chutney, dates chutney, and the pudina, that is the green chutney, which they make using coriander, mint, some lime juice, green chilies, and some garlic. So that is garlic flavored. So I already have some chutneys in the fridge, which I got some time back. Now this is Delhi chaat. So this is all-in-one chutney. This is primarily used for chaat. And there's dates and tamarind chutney, which is almost over. And I'm going to use this for my video purpose. So this is coriander mint chutney. This is over. This bottle is khali. I don't know why I have this bottle still in my fridge. So the chaats are incomplete without these chutneys. They add so much of flavor and soul to the chaat. So it's a must and should. And these apart, for the very first time, I saw something interesting, as in kulcha. These were available, but then I never thought of buying. But then now kids have vacation, so especially Yash, he wanted to try kulchas. Now this is a very famous street food, especially in Delhi, I guess. So they serve this with chana. So chole kulcha. So that is chickpeas, which we make North Indian style, nice Punjabi style. So I'm planning to make this probably one of these days. This has a shelf life of 5 days. So maybe one of these days I'm planning to make this for dinner, or maybe an evening snack, or even for breakfast. So I've not decided. So I've never tried, but this is the first time I'm buying the packaged stuff. So this is the very famous street food kulcha, chole kulcha. Chole kulche. So let me see how this tastes. So this is a very bad habit of Atharv. So whenever a bag comes in after shopping, he has this bad habit of raiding it. I don't know what he is searching or what he expects to be there. I don't know, probably something for him to eat, and now he wants something to eat. So I'm asking him to eat these bananas, and he is eating something else without washing his hands. know the baby? Baby's name is?
Amani.
Amani. Make the baby.